Hey guys, and welcome to the next episode. In this episode, we are talking about the registration. Actually, we are creating the registration on Unity, and then we are saving the account we are sending from the client to the server on the MySQL database. So the account will exist forever till you delete it or whatever. First of all, I had a major problem on the last episode where I couldn't store any data on the MySQL database. The reason was because there was a setting problem on the MySQL database on the table. I will actually show you what fixes the problem there. So if you go back to your database table on accounts, right click and then redesign the table. The problem was the ID, okay? First of all, you need, when you double click the table, you need to delete every entry here. So you press Control A and then you just delete everything you did in there. And then you go back to the design table. And then you have to add auto increment and unassigned. So the ID will auto increase every time a new account appears. That was the problem why the error showed up. Yeah, that's basically the fix from the last video. And today we are working on the server and on the client to make the client ready to register an account. And also we are starting with a fresh, clean scene. So you know how to set up everything and how to do everything. So we are starting actually with the server first, so we can set up the data. So first of all, if you downloaded the project files from the second video, you can actually delete all of this. When you go into network send data, okay, you can delete public join game, and also you can delete send instantiate player, and also you can delete send get other player, because we are rewriting everything. Okay, if you have deleted this, maybe some error will appear. Next, you go to client CS, and then. No, actually not. You go to network. Yeah, there's your error down below at the bottom. You see the error global network send data send join game does not exist anymore because we have deleted it, and we are going to delete this as well. Okay, now we can start with the MySQL connection stuff. So first of all, we are going to check if everything is all right. We can actually delete or we need this, but we commented it out because we don't want to add a user right away when we starting the server. We just want to add a user into the database when the server sends a request from the client to the server. Okay, how we do that? So first of all, we are going into our network handle data and we add a new packet to our list, so the server knows what to do when the client sends this packet. So we say packets.add. The packet number is 1, and then we need a packet value. For that, we scroll down below handle data. We minimize that below, or we state so below handle data. We need a callback, so we say void handle. Handle new account. That's it. We need an index from our player, and we need a byteArray where it stores all of our data. As next, we do need our KMakeGames DLL. We call this buffer equals new KMakeGames.KMakeGames, or you can use your own DLL we have created in the second video, I guess. You just have to add it as a reference here in the client project, and then you can use your own. But the KMakeGames DLL is basically the same DLL file which we have created in the second video. Alright, to read out the data now, we created a new instance of the buffer, and then we need to write out the data. So we say buffer.writeBytes our data, and then we can read out anything we want. We send from the client to the server. Okay. Now we are going into our database script to make a new function. This function will actually store the data in the database. For that we need to create a new object. We call this we need to create a new function first before we can create an object. So we say public void add account. So what do we need for adding a new account? We need a string, the username of the player, and we also need another string that is the password of the player. And then we need now a new object, and now we are accessing the MySQL class. For that we need to say var global, if I'm correct, var dbrs equals globals dot not database dot mysql dot dbrs. Okay, and now we can access the MySQL database. We can use the connection we have created in the MySQL class right here, and now we can we also can use the new instance of the record set, so we can read out and write data into the table. And now when we look at here, we just copy and paste this one. For that, db open will say it's an error because we said dbrs, so we can just say we change that on top. And now we are going to select everything from the table accounts, and we do need a connection. So we need to access the MySQL class again. So that means globals.mysql.dbcon, and that's it. Now we are opening up this table, the account table right there. Game database. Now we open up the account table. Now we can store anything we want. Do me a favor, always when you open up the table, after you open up the table, you have to close it. So I always write down db.close, because I always forget that, and then I'm looking for the error, because when you're not closing the table after you did your stuff and open up another table, then you will get tons of errors. And then you are looking through the source code and changing stuff and doing even more worse stuff and all kinds of that. And at the end, you didn't basically close the database. And that happened multiple times to me, and I was like sleepless for days. And why the error happens? And then I saw by accident, I didn't close the MySQL database table, and basically I destroyed the whole source code. And anyway, that's basically a different story. So how do we store a new entry into the table? So at first we, of course, db.addNew. That means you are adding a new row into this table, so a new user into this table. And then we can say db.fields, the fields value, of course, equals username. Okay, and then we, of course, we have a field of password, and then we say fields password dot value equals password, and the first field is username. So we have to write it the same way as we write it here, username and password, because the fields will look out if the field even exists, and if it exists, it will save the data into this field. And if you mistype it, you will get a tons of error. But we did it, and then we want to save it into this database. That's why we say db.update, so the data gets saved. Okay, that's it for saving a new account. We can also make a check if the user already exists, but for that we are doing that later. And for now we just want to store any data into the database so you know how it works. Then we are going back into our network handle data, and at the end from the comments we say globals.database.addAccount, and we want we need two strings. We need a username and password, and we currently don't have anyone. That's why we have to go back to our client and send the two strings, the username and the password, from the client to the server. And how do we do that? So you open up the Unity project. As I said, if you didn't download the project files like the client handle data, client send data, network and net player, you can do that in the second video of the series. There is a link in the description where you can download the files. And actually I already had set up a new scene, but for you guys I'm creating a new scene so you know how to set up the things with the scripts. So in the fresh new scene, we right click and create a new game object. We call this game object network manager, or whatever you want. And into this network manager, we add actually our network script to connect to the server. We add our client handle data script to receive data, and we add our client send data script to actually send data. And then we add our net player for later purpose. Okay, as you can see, there are some settings that's not necessary for now. You can set up your server IP where you want to connect your server port. You don't have to do anything on the client handle data yet. And on the client send data, it's necessary to drag and drop the network from here, from the network manager, into the network object. So you get the reference of the script, so you can send data to the server. And that's it. You successfully created your connection to the server. Pretty simple, right? Okay, now we are creating the registration window. For that, we right click in the hierarchy, we create a new UI, we create a canvas. In this canvas, we create a new input field, and we create another input field, and we create an, a button. There you go. Okay, the first input field we call input username. The second input field we call input password, and the button we just call button register. Okay, now we just position everything: username, password, and the registration button. And I'm doing some GUI stuff, placeholder, enter username ... and in input password, the placeholder will be enter password ... Okay, now we did set up the GUI. I'm not going to save the scene. And now we have to code something. So we are going directly into our client send data script and double click on it to open it. And on top, directly, we create a new header. We call this header registration. On top, we are adding using unityengine.ui. And then under the header, we add a public text underscore username. And under that, we add another text underscore password. So what happens now, if we hit save, control S to save that, we go back to our Unity client. And as you can see, in a second, there will appear a new tab, the registration, username and password. So now we are going to drag and drop the text from our input username into the registration username text object, and the same we will do with the input password text. Okay, to get the reference of what we are typing in into those fields. Then we are going back into the script, and then we create a new function. We call this function public void send new account. Okay, to send a new account or to send data, which we already talked about in the first or second video, we create a new reference of our DLL. Again, you can use your own DLL we have created in the second video, or you just can use my DLL. It's actually the same stuff in there. If you want to use your own DLL, you have to add it into your Unity client. Okay, we add all the reference. We want to write bytes to the... No, we don't want to write bytes. We just want to add stuff to the buffer. So we want, if I'm correct, we added the packet number 1 here into our packets. So we add the new integer. So we say buffer.write integer. That's our packet name. It's number 1. So the server knows which packet he has to read out and which function he has to execute. And then we are sending our username and our password. For that we say not butter. We say buffer.write string. And we say underscore username. Username dot text, and for our password we say underscore write string dot password dot text. All right, and that's it. We are sending an integer, our packet number, and then we are sending two strings, our username and our password. At the end of this function we say send data to server, and we want our buffer dot to array, and then we are good to go. I always say buffer equals null, so it resets. So our send new account is now done. We now can successfully send... Oh no, it's actually not done. I'm sorry, I'm lying. We go back to our client, wait till everything is compiled. There you go, no errors. That's awesome. We go on our button register, scroll down in the inspector. On the onClick event, the list is empty. So we go and add a new event when we are clicking on the plus. Then we drag and drop our network manager into this non object. We click on function. We go on client send data and we say send new account. Now the button has the function to execute this code, and then the code will get executed when we press the button. Okay. Now we are ready to go, I think. We are going back to our server. And now we go back to our handle new account function. And now we are going to read out the packet. So at first we are reading out the the username, right? So we say the buffer.readstring. No, we are doing it differently. We say string username equals buffer dot read string. Then we say string password equals buffer dot read string. Always make sure you read out the packet the same way as you send it. At first we did send an integer, so we need to read out first the integer. So buffer dot read integer. And then we did send a password at a username, so we read out the string username, and then we read out as last one the user the password. And then we execute the account, the add account function, that we say username and our string password. Now we are sending the values to the database function, and the database function will execute it and add it into the database. But first, we also have to add the packet list. So we have added, where is it? In the handle data, we have added, of course, the packet. We copy and paste the handle new account into there. Now, when the server gets a packet, he reads out the packet and gets the first number he gets. We added the number one, so he knows, the number one, he need to execute the handle new account function. And but first of all, we need to instantiate this this dictionary into the server. And for that, we are going into the program class, and right here above the where we initialize. Oh my god, the word! Seriously, I should stop talking English. After we initialize the server, there you go. We need to initialize actually the dictionary so the server can listen to those packages. So we need to say globals.networkhandledata.initializeMessages, and that's it. Now we are ready to go and start the server. Come on, and then we can start the client and test actually if we did everything right. Starting, there you go. The connection to my SQL server was successfully, the server has successfully started. And now we can go into our client. We just hit play. And then we type in Kevin, the third, and my password, and now we are sending the username and the password to the server, and the server saves it into database. I pressed a button, I pressed it, and nothing happens. Of course nothing happens, because we haven't any log file, but actually something happened. When we go into our account database and hit refresh, nothing happened. Okay, I press it again. What happened? There you go. The account now successfully is created in the database and got saved. Now we can actually, I don't know, add another name like this one and this one. Hit the register button correctly, not like me. Refresh the database, and as you can see, the next account was created. And that's how you save data into the MySQL database. And yeah, that's it. And in the next video, we are going to look at how you can log in into the game by using those information from the database, and how you get the values. So I hope you guys like it. Don't forget to join my Discord server. You can write me on Facebook. The link is down below in the description. And yeah, you can also subscribe maybe as you want, but that's up to you. So yeah, see you in the next video. Bye.